Hello everyone, I'm going to work on the coasters again because I thought they need something special. But first of all I want to thank Maria. Maria, thanks so much for supporting me and also that way support this channel. I can't tell you how much I appreciate what you did, so thanks a lot for that. So, yeah, the coasters. I thought they were finished, but I looked at them again and I thought, no, they need a little something special. And I watched some videos and I saw this dotting art. And I thought, maybe I can put some details of that on my coasters. So that's what you see me do now. I'm placing some acrylic dots on the coasters, and the colors I'm using are listed in this video and also in the description box. So if you want to see which ones, then you can check out the description box. Yeah, normally they have special tools to place all those dots, but I searched in my home and I found something and I'm using that. So I'm using some Pergamano pens. I don't know if you know what it is, but we call it Pergamano. And they have a very small metal tip on it. And with that I can place the smaller dots. And I'm using copper and some violet and a magenta color. Yeah, and I'm using for this dotting art the deco art colors, because what I learned is that the consistency of the paint needs to be the consistency of the deco art color. So I'm using the dazzling metallics, the copper one, and the other two are the deco art Americana paint. So no water added, so straight out of the bottle. And I'm not going to show you all four coasters because this is very time consuming. And that's why I only show one coaster. So after this is done, then I need to let it dry. And then they will get a clear coat. You can already see that I sanded the coaster before I put these acrylic dots on them. And I sand with 400 grit sandpaper, and then I clean it with alcohol. And this is very relaxing to do. I like it. I never done it before. So maybe in the future I will do a bigger piece of this, combining it with resin. And I hope they will look nice if I put a clear coat on top of them. But it's something different, and I like it. Normally we put some acrylic lines on them, but I thought maybe I can do something different than I normally do. And what I also saw when they do these kinds of art is that they draw lines on paper or on canvas. But yeah, I can't do it on a resin, so I need to do it freehand. But I don't mind. I like to do this. So almost done with the dots, because I don't want to add too much, because otherwise they get very busy and I don't like that. So not too much. A little bit closer so you can see what I just did. There you can see all the dots, the smaller ones, the bigger ones, the colors up close. So the acrylic paint has dried and now I can add a clear coat. Because they need one, and they also need to be a little bit thicker for coasters. I taped the back, and I also, what I didn't tell you, is that I also sanded the sharp edge I had on the last layer, before I put the acrylic paint on top of it. So, yeah, now I can put the clear coat on top, also over the sides. So I'm putting some clear with my stirring stick on the coasters, spread it around. And you don't need a lot for these four coasters. I only need 100 milliliters and then I have enough. It needs to be only a thin layer. Yeah, I always start in the middle and then I work my way out to the outside and not over the edge. Now a little bit of heat to let it make it more liquid and let it flow to the edge. Now I'm going to add more clear, more to the sides so that it also can flow over the sides. There you can see me do it. I'm letting it flow over the sides. Yeah, and I'm really happy with the colors of these coasters. They go very well. They're very sparkly. I like it a lot. And also with the interference pigment I'm using, yeah, it's very nice. If yeah, you need to see them in person, because I can't show it that well on video. Also not the depth, because they have great depth. But yeah. Working on the sides again, because all the sides have been sanded, so they need to shine again. So need to make sure that the sides are all covered with the resin. Again, some heat for the air bubbles, but also to make it more liquid. Now it can flow over the sides. Yeah, again I'm working on the side, and I with my stirring stick I'm spreading the resin around onto my side. Making sure I cover every spot on the side. Also at the end of this video, a close-up Then you can see the acrylic design I put on top of the coaster up close, and also I hope that you can see the depth and the sparkle and the colors in daylight. So if you want to see that, then you can wait until the end of this video. Yeah, I'm looking at the coasters in all directions so that I can see that I don't miss a spot in the reflection of the light. Also that I don't have any dust or hairs or whatsoever in it, because that's not nice if it dries and you have a hair in your resin. So I'm almost done with the sides, and then I hope they will dry okay. But yeah, you never know, because yeah, to get it all dust free is very difficult. So the torch for the air bubbles, and then I'm all done with the clear coat, and then we can go to the close-up. So this is how they look after 24 hours of drying, and also in the daylight. And yeah, I'm very pleased how they look. They sparkle a lot, and I like the design that I made on top with acrylic paint. And yeah, it's totally different than we normally see, but I like to do things that aren't usual. So that's why I placed these dots on top of it, of the coasters. Yeah, and the colors are very nice. They sparkle a lot. And also the glass glitter I added. Yeah, it's nice. And they it has a great depth. Yeah, you can't see it in the video. A little bit closer. There you can see the design I made on top of it. With the colors, the copper, the magenta and the violet, light violet. There also, and all the different shades of purple. And they dried very well. No dust in it, no hair, so I'm very pleased. So, if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video. If you have tips, comments or questions, place them under the video or send me an email. All the links you want to know are in the description box. Please check out my Amazon store, because also there I have some links of materials I'm using, and you help me a little bit. I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!